Father, you are today. We give you thanks. We give you praise. We glorify and magnify your name for what you already have done. God, we ask that you come in the midst of us. Have your way in this place. Be in every one of us. Be in every song. Be in every preached word. God, we will glorify you and magnify you because you deserve it. You're a great God. You're an awesome God. You are a healer. You're a deliverer. And you are the one that set us free. So we honor you on this day, God, praising you in advance for what you're about to do in this place. Have your way, God. Have your way, God, in this place, God. We come here to magnify and glorify you, God, because it's all about you. So, God, we will honor you in everything that we do and say. Help us, God, even in this service, in the furtherance of this service. Just saturate us, God, with your presence, God. Because the reason we're here is to give you glory. And these things we ask in your Son, Jesus' name. Amen.
Come on, saints, all out in virtual land. Come on and join in with us. How many of you want the Lord to search you? How many of you want the Lord to search you? Come on, say, search me, Lord. It's the whole thing for you to do. If you got somebody in the room, look at him and say, I want to search me. I want the Lord to search me. Come on, come on, get me.
Yeah.
stay right in his presence. It's been another day and another week that he's kept you. I dare you to lift your hands. You might not have done it yet. And if you have, ain't nothing wrong with doing it again. Let the Redeemer of the Lord say so. I dare you to lift your hands and tell him, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We're going to go and worship for a moment. Oh Lord, we give you praise. Oh Lord, we give you praise. You can leave it up, brother Matt, it's okay. Oh Lord, we bless your name. How many of you believe out there in virtual land that he can meet you right there in your bedroom? He can meet you right there in your living room. And all to feel the presence of the Lord. Bless you. All to feel the presence of his refreshing spirit that uplifts the soul, breaks the chain. But you gotta give him praise and honor. You gotta acknowledge him. We don't take a moment and acknowledge our Lord and Savior, King of Kings, Alpha and Omega, beginning to begin. We're about to acknowledge him in song. You can join me in all the living. Oh Lord, we give you praise. Thank you.
Praise the Lord, everybody, for your goodness and your mercy towards us. We've not been in this pandemic now since March. It's around the fifth month. Some of us have suffered loss. But even for those that have suffered loss, when we really think of the goodness of Jesus and all that God has done for us, we owe him a hallelujah for your goodness and your mercy toward us. For those of you that are listening, I just want you to look around your surroundings. If you have shelter over your head, I want you to tell the Lord thank you. If you had breakfast this morning, or if you have a dinner scheduled for this afternoon, I just want you to tell the Lord thank you. If you have a job to go to, either at home or in an office, or if you have been laid off, but yet all of your needs have been supplied, I want you to lift up your voice and tell God thank you. Come on, from the depths of your soul. For every storm that you've been through, for every valley that you have to fall through, every mountain that you have to go over, God has been with you every step of the way. So we lift up our voices and our hands. Come on, open up your mouth and tell God thank you. Hallelujah. Come on, come on. Come on, thank you, God. Give us a praise. Hallelujah. 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 And your mercy towards us. Giving God praise on a Sunday morning. Amen. But I thank God for the choir. I thank God for these that have come in to just give some songs on today. And I thank God for you out there. Amen. I am thankful. Amen. I know it could be different, but I'm thankful. Because we yet have a place to come to. It's comfortable in this little room and we can come together, even in our social distancing, and we can yet tell the Lord thank you. I look forward to the next few weeks, what God has planned for us. I pray for this nation. I pray for this nation. I pray for the leadership of this nation. I pray for the states that the numbers have been astronomical. I pray for you. I pray for California, where our presiding bishop is. I pray for Texas and Arizona. I pray for all the states that are going through. And I pray that God will send relief and eradicate this virus. Is there anything too hard for God? I should have heard somebody say no. There's somebody that can respond to that. I want you to type in that number that there is nothing too hard for God. Come on, do that one more time. Is there anything too hard for God? My daughter, I believe the Bible. And I believe when the Bible says that if my people which are called by my name will humble themselves and seek his faith and just pray, then he gonna turn some things around. I need somebody to get up right where you are and say, God, I belong to you. And Father, I need you to turn this thing around. Come on, turn this thing around. Turn to St. John, the fifth chapter on today. Amen. The fifth chapter. Amen. We're going to just come to you for a few minutes of what God has pressed on my heart. Amen. I want you to say with me, I'm done with this party. I'm done with this party. Now, some of you may have gone and done things in your life where you went places that it just wasn't where you were supposed to be, where you wanted to be, where you needed to be, but yet you felt obligated to be there. You felt pressured by societal pressures to be in a place, even in relationships, jobs, places where you just did not need to be. Where you sit up looking for things in life that is not there. Turning over stones. Nothing under the stones but some old dirt. But because somebody done told you to get up and turn the stone over 3 times in a row. And you believe that. Turn the stone over. I'm just making something up. Because you know that's really what it is. Something somebody made up. And over the years, it grows into folklore. It becomes the real deal. All right. Now we're going to read a story here. And I want you, after we have read this, I want you to make a decision about your future with God. The Bible says, after this, there was a feast. And Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now there is at Jerusalem by the sheep market a pool, which is called in the Hebrew tongue Bethesda, having 5 porches. I want you to circle these scriptures here. In these lay a great multitude of impotent, blind, halt, withered, waiting for the moving of the water. Did you hear what I said?
Yes, sir.
Not waiting for the move of God, but then waiting for the move of the water. This is why I say I'm done with this party, because so many people are sitting up in life looking at the imaginary water, thinking it's the water that's going to save your life. That it's the water that's going to bring redemption. Some lady feels like that man that's in the grocery store is all they need. If I can find me a man that loves his mom and go to the grocery store for his mom. If I can find that woman that cooks dinner. If I can find that job. If I can find this, then everything is going to be all right. But can I tell you this right now? You're looking in the wrong place.
Well,
you ought to say, I've been looking in the wrong places. Hallelujah. They were blind, can't see, couldn't see. Isn't that even customary of what's going on even in this country? Some people can't see or realize that there is something wrong in this land. There's a virus that needs to be respected. it needs to be admonished, and there needs to be some guidelines even in our lives if we're going to get through it. They are blind, can't see the road, the vision, the dream. And if you can't see it, then you can't understand it. I need you to understand this. If you can't see it, you can't understand it. Now, a lot of people are trying to understand things that they can't even see. The thing is that we have to have faith in God. Because the Bible says that we walk by faith and not by sight. I understand this. I understand this, that God is my all. And without him, I am nothing. Listen, your education is nothing. The money in your bank is nothing. Because there may be a time when the banks may close. You hear what I'm saying? We are near the time that Jesus is soon to come. Can I say that one more time? Yes. Jesus is soon to come. The rapture is about to take place any moment. Jesus is soon to come. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready to answer the call? Have you been faithful to Jesus at all? When the Lord makes that call in the morning, are you ready to be with Jesus in the morning? I don't know about you, but I'm ready right now. Mother Martin preached that message one time. I'm ready right now. How many of you can say, I'm ready right now? My sins have been forgiven. I've been washed in the blood. And my blood, my life is clean and spotless because of the guiltless Lamb of Jesus Christ. I am clean and ready to go right now. Why? Impotent. Folks who cannot take effective action. Helpless, powerless, sick, impotent, blind, halt, those who can't walk, unable to move, looking at the water. And there are people in life, situations in life, where people are stuck in place and they can't move, and they can't see, and they can't understand, and they're impotent to even make a change. And they're withered, that finally they're withered, which means to be paralyzed. They are paralyzed, and that is a terrible place to be, is when you cannot move. And the thing about it, I thought about this. People that are in a place of paralysis, but yet the mind that God has made for us is always thinking. It's always moving. But yet in a state of paralysis, I can't move. I want you to hear me on today. I'm done with this party. When I get finished in the next few minutes, I want you to make a decision that whatever place that you're in, yes, that you're blind, that you are impotent, that you are lame, and that you're finally paralyzed, that you're going to say, I'm done with this party on today. I'm not looking for a man. I'm not looking for a woman. I'm not looking or counting on my bank account or job. All I am is I'm looking to Jesus. I need you to come. I need you to type that and say, I'm looking to Jesus. Come on, somebody, say, I'm looking to Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of my faith. He is the author, and finisher of my faith. So can I say this? I'm sorry. I don't want to be in no parties where even if I don't have no friends, no compatriots, no migas, no amigos, no hanging parties, I want to be around somebody that knows how to praise in a sad situation. I need to be around somebody that knows that there's victory in your praise. Come on, somebody, tell somebody there. Victory in your praise. I don't want to be in a party no more where folks can't, oh, woe is me. My man done left me. And my job done laid me off. But I need somebody that says, you know what? Yet in all things I will bless the Lord. Oh, my soul and all that is within me. Come on, somebody, you that are in the room, lift up a praise party unto God right now. I'm done with this party. Listen, I want to tell you this. David, the Bible says in 1 Samuel, there was a situation where King David had to escape to the cave of Adullam. And the Bible says when his brethren and all his father's house heard it, they went down hither. And everyone that was in distress, and everyone that was in debt, and everyone that was discontented gathered themselves. Listen, you ought to ask yourself, who hanging around me? Who hanging around me? Brother man, who hanging around you with your cool self? You need somebody that's going to hang around you that's about something and going to do something in life that's making a positive move. And I don't want no broke folks, and I understand sometimes people don't have money. But I need to know that you're moving and you're about to get something because you have a plan that God has given you. Everyone that was in distress, everyone that was in debt, everyone that was discontented, they were in that cave hovering amongst themselves because... Hallelujah. Somebody in the enemy was looking for them. I preached on this a few years ago, that this cave is not going to be my grave. I need you to understand that this cave, and you might be in the cave right now, but I'm here to tell you today that you can make a statement and say, I'm done with this party. Is anybody going to say, I'm done with this party? I'm done with this party. The Bible says that an angel came down at certain season into the pool and troubled the water. Whosoever then, first after the trouble of the water, stepped in was made whole of whatsoever disease he had. And a certain man was there which had an infirmity 38 years. It was 38 years looking at the water. I can't fathom that. 38 years, I'm staying in the same place. 5 years, I'm in the same place. Yeah. 10 years, I'm in the same place. Because I'm waiting for some kind of mystical change. Something that somebody told me, all you got to do is just hang on here. Have you ever seen anybody else get it? It's just like the lottery. Listen, those of you that play the lottery, God bless your soul. But I'm not going to sit and wait for a 1 in a 50 million chance of making my day. I'm not going to sit up there and believe some dream that I had is going to give me some magical numbers. Lord, I dreamed I saw my grandma, and she was born on February 8, 1996. My grandma. And she was born, so I'm going to run those numbers, 02081996. Go ahead, that's the number. God done gave it to me in a dream. I'm about to be rich. And all of a sudden, you're going to put all your money, your hard-earned money. Am I talking to anybody on today? You ought to say today, I'm done with this party. I'm done with this party. There's no dream. There's no circumstance. You don't have to turn the salt shake over 4 or 5 times. Hallelujah. Lord, the water. I'm waiting on the water 38 years. The Bible says there was a certain man with an infirmity 38 years. A multitude of needy people were there. Yet none of them looked at Jesus. Listen to that. Yet none of them looked at Jesus. Not a one. They were looking at the water. They were looking at the water. But the one who can heal them walked in. Yeah. The one that can heal them and turn everything around walked in. And even when they walked in, they were yet looking at the water. What are you looking at today? With all of the folks that are lame, all of the folks that are impotent, all of the folks that can't move, what are you looking at? None of them looked at Jesus. The Bible says a blindness had come over these people at the pool. They were there. And there was Christ who could heal them, but not a single one of them saw him. The eyes were fixed on the water, expecting at any moment it to be troubled. They were so taken up by their own chosen way that their true way was neglected. Can you imagine the multitude of those waiting around the pool? How foolish can you be? Waiting for a convenient season. Waiting for dreams and visions. Waiting for signs and wonders. Some waiting for some kind of being compelled. You know how somebody, the Lord told me, Can I tell you this? I get so sick folks telling me, the Lord has told me. The Lord has told me. What did the Lord tell you? Waiting for some kind of revival. When the revival has come, the lines are full of folks that just want a touch from God. But can I tell you this? Your word, that's what God, that's how God is going to move.
Yes, sir.
That's how he's going to fix it in his word.
Yes, sir.
This ought to be your best friend. This is your barometer. Yes. This is the liner to your path. Yes. This is how God is going to fix it. But wait, look, the revival is good because we need revival. We need a revival. The Bible said, David said, Lord, will thou not revive us again? We need a revival. But it's not a revival that's going to alter your destiny. It is the word of God. Some folks wait for particular feelings. Some folks wait for a celebrity. If Michael Jordan come out with a new shoe, if I can just get a new shoe. I ain't got nothing against Michael Jordan. I watch just about every game that he played. I love me some Michael Jordan. But Michael Jordan ain't never put a dime in my pocket. I done put a lot in his pocket. My few little dimes and all your dimes and all your dimes that made him who he is today. But Michael Jordan, Magic Johnson, none of them have done nothing. And so, as I come to a close, I'm tired of this party. The Bible says when Jesus saw him and knew that he had been a long time in that case, he said unto him these simple words. Do you want to be healed? Do you want to be made whole? Do you want to be made whole? Let me ask you today, do you want to be made whole? Do you want to be free from the bondages that hold you? All through the Bible, there was times when God spoke in different ways. Second Kings, there was a pot of stew. Naaman, in 2 Kings, was healed by washing in the river of Jordan. One was healed by touching the bones of Elisha. He was raised up from the dead. Some were healed when the shadow of Peter fell upon them. Some were healed when Paul's handkerchiefs were laid upon them. I'm just here to tell you today, it is not your old way, but God moves in different ways. I'm almost coming to a close, but the impotent man, he answered him and said, sir, I have no man. Make an excuse. I have no man to put me in the water when it's troubled. Jesus said unto him, rise up, take your bed, and walk. Simple words from the one who can make it happen. I'm here today to tell you today, you're at the wrong party. You're at the wrong party. Look to the word. Look to Jesus Christ. Can I tell you this? Joe Biden, Donald Trump is not the answer. Governor Pritzker, Mary Lightfoot is not the answer. But when you see it and understand it, you immediately can take hold. The Bible says immediately the man was made whole. I can surmise even in my mind that when Jesus spoke those words, that there was a quickening in his feet. All of a sudden, muscles and bones all of a sudden that for 38 years had not moved. All of a sudden, he felt a quickening in his feet. I want you to know that if you say yes to the Lord right now, something is going to change. You're not going to even know. You're not going to even understand. But there was a quickening. God healed him because he saw it and he understood. I want to say to you today, if you're out here and you had a party, a dead-end party, nobody's happy. Nobody's excited. everybody's in the doldrums. Everybody's blind, paralyzed, lame, can't make rational decisions. Get you some folks, as the Bible says, even in Timothy, to worship with those that call on the Lord out of a pure heart. Find you some prayer partners. Find you some worship partners. Get you some new relationships. Somebody that can pick you up and lift you up, even in the spirit. Because there's going to be days of trouble. There's going to be days of pain. But your prayer partners can pull you through. And likewise, also you. But when you get those calls that I'm going through, instead of crying, begin to give praise. Begin to give God some praise. Begin to give God some praise. The Bible says to strengthen those that are weak, we that are strong. Strengthen those that are weak. I need somebody that can carry me through in my darkest hour.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I just want you to point your hands even to me. And even as a spiritual contact. I want you to say, Lord, I'm tired of the party that I'm in. I'm tired of the friends, God, that don't worship you, that don't acknowledge you, that don't even know you. Father, I pray now, God, that you will change my environment. Rise, my sister. Rise, my brother. Take up your bed and walk. When you say yes to the Lord, he's going to turn it around. Now, I just want you to begin to worship the Lord. Hallelujah. Worship the Lord right where you are. Worship God.
Come on, do that one more time. Oh.
Lord, in total surrender. Oh, where you are. Things that you have to do to snip even that relationship, but God's going to help you to come back stronger than ever. New roots. I see new roots. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I see new roots. There's going to be a new root. There's going to be a new root. God's gonna do it. I want you to claim it, my sister, my brother. You that are at the point of separation from your marriage, thus saith the Lord, get to your quiet place. You and your spouse, leave the phones and the TVs and everything. Get rid of it. And just be in a quiet place with you and your spouse. God's going to reformulate your love. He's going to do it. He's going to do it. You're ready to go to the courthouse right now, but the devil is a lie. 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 Turn it around, God. Turn it around, God. You, sister, you're about to kill yourself. You plan to kill yourself. Not so. Not so. In the mighty, matchless name of Jesus, I curse death. I come against the spirit of suicide in the name of Jesus. Flee! How about you? In the name of Jesus. It is so in Jesus' name. If you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, say these words with me. Father, forgive me of my sins. I am a sinner, and I deserve eternal damnation. Father, I pray that you come into my life be the Lord of my life. And fill me with your precious gift of the Holy Ghost. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. It is so. I want you to clap your hands and say, it is so. It is so. It is so. In Jesus' name. It is so. Come on, somebody. It is so. I feel it in my spirit. I feel the spirit of release. It is so. Hallelujah. It is so. Hallelujah. It is so. It is so. It is so. Come on, play your victory. God's going to give you the victory to walk away from that dead father, that dead person, that dead situation. Wait for a miracle that's on the side. But when you look to the healer, from the top of your health, your health, it comes from the Lord. Come on, somebody. My health comes from the Lord. My health is coming from God. For coming to visit us on today. Amen. If you have a time and an offering that you would love to share with us, amen. The mission would love to have it. Amen. We're doing some good things and we are going to be doing this. This corona is not destroying us, it's making us better. We're going to come out of this better. Church is going to grow, membership is going to grow, those who love the Lord is going to grow. New mission, we've been around 15 years. And that's the same for your situation. This situation is not going to destroy you, it's going to make you better. Now, I don't know if you really believe that, but I believe it in my soul that it's going to be better. Lord, I feel like praising God. Give them a praise right where they are.
grave right where they are. We're gonna go all the way.